Jamie is a Wrike account admin at a software company. They're rolling out Wrike in their organization and are about to invite users to the account. Before that, Jamie needs to check and adjust different levels of user permissions in Wrike to ensure everyone has the appropriate access. First, he configures user types that should exist in the account. A user type determines account-wide capabilities and limitations for users. Every account has default user types with predetermined permissions. Full license users include admins, regular users, and external users. They have various default permissions that can be enabled. Limited users have fewer permissions and limited access to certain Wrike features. Check Wrike Help Center for more information on user types. Jamie modifies the external user type by renaming it, as it will be assigned exclusively to partners. He changes some permissions for partners, such as the ability to delete projects and folders. Jamie creates a new user type for customers based on the partner type, but he revokes rights for making changes, like updating statuses, tracking time, and uploading files. When inviting new users, Jamie and other admins select the relevant user type to ensure correct account-level permissions. Anticipating more users from various teams, Jamie proactively creates user groups. He groups individuals from the same departments and locations together, streamlining information sharing and access rights management. He adds existing users as group members. Then, Jamie assigns department managers as group admins. They can add and remove users, as well as create, rename, and delete subgroups. Michelle, the design team manager, creates a space for her team and adds the design team user group to the space members. This immediately gives all group members access to the space, eliminating the need to add them individually. When a new designer is later invited to Wrike and added to the group, they instantly gain access to the design team space, as well as all other items shared with the group. As a user group admin, Michelle creates two subgroups for the motion and graphic design teams and moves the team members as necessary. If something needs to be shared only with motion designers, the respective subgroup can be used. For wider team announcements or shares, the parent design team group can be chosen. This use of subgroups allows for a hierarchy, effectively reflecting a department's organizational structure. All Wrike accounts have a My Team user group that includes all regular users. This allows for efficient communication via quick invitation of all regular users to spaces, easy tagging, and item sharing. Design team members have regular user licenses, granting them full rights to create and edit within the workspace. User types can later be adjusted in user settings, along with other parameters. From this menu, admins are able to deactivate, reactivate, and delete users. A user type defines what a user can see and do within the account. However, the same user can have different levels of access to various items. This is regulated by access roles. The design team has full access to their space, enabling them to edit information within it. However, they are granted read-only access to the release plan space, managed by another team, as their role there is to view information, not to make changes. When setting access rights within a shared folder, project, or space, choose among these default access roles: full, editor, limited, and read-only. For spaces, an additional admin role is available to manage space settings. Click See All Permissions to learn more about the default access roles. But what if a more precise user action control is required? Jamie creates a custom access role to permit users to create and edit tasks, but not manage projects or folders. This provides granular control and ensures each team member has an access level most suited to their responsibilities. With the ability to specify user types, create user groups, and set access levels, Wrike perfectly balances security and productivity, allowing Jamie to successfully set up users and ensure his team works efficiently